weird. Never seen the beaches empty before.
Never been the scene of a sudden death of a Marine before.
No official COD yet?
Marine Corporal Jasper Kanahele stepped into a tide pool and 30 seconds later had a massive seizure and died. Reason number 67 why I never stepped foot in the water.
Figured living with Whistler, she would have got you on a surfboard by now.
Oh, our love is strong, but not surfboard strong.
Look, you do know what happened here is really unusual, right? The ocean didn't give him a seizure.
All I know for sure is feet, water, day, so.
Yeah, well, I'm sure Commander Chase can give us some context.
Let me know what she says.
You're really not coming?
I'm really not.
Mm-mm. Feet, water, death. Got it.
I swabbed his nose and mouth, came up negative. Drugs likely entered his bloodstream through abrasions on his feet.
So we're chalking this up as a tragic accident, then?
I wouldn't be so sure of that. MCRT just handed me these. 6 more bags of fentanyl scattered across the beach. We're now up to 14 bags across 3 beaches. None extend past the high tide line.
So they washed ashore. Okay, get the geolocation data to Ernie so he can try to triangulate.
On a bus.
Spread the word. Guys, no one travels without a drug rescue kit. Not until this case is over.
Hey, what do we know about fentanyl on the island?
It's everywhere. Some of it stolen from hospitals and pharmacies, most of it imported from outside sources.
What about the bags we found?
Based on chemical analysis, it's 100% pure. And it's been flooding the island for months.
Any idea who's bringing it in?
FBI and DEA believe it's a Caldero cartel out of Colombia.
Why would a Colombian cartel run drugs through Hawaii?
Either as a distribution hub, ferrying narcotics from China where they're made to the mainland, or they're manufacturing them here.
In the islands?
It's hard to tell. It's the first real evidence the Calderos are operating here at all.
Well, hopefully it'll get us closer to shutting them down.
Just need to find out how those drugs wash up on the beach.
That's insanity! You hear yourself, right? You're saying I need to spend $60,000 just to fix it up and then still lose $20,000 when I sell? That's not how math works. By your logic, I should just burn it down and take the insurance. Kidding, I'm totally kidding. I'll get back to you.
You selling your place?
No, my father's place.
Your father?
It's a long story.
So tell me.
My father passed the other month. Left me some property I need to get rid of. Oh, guess it's not a long story.
God, Ernie, I'm so sorry.
Real estate's a fickle game.
No, I'm sorry about your dad.
There's nothing to be sorry about.
He died the other month. He didn't say anything.
There's nothing worth saying, so. Anyway, I inputted the geolocation data where our drugs were found. Based on current patterns and a little help from an algorithm I wrote, I'm 98.6% sure the fentanyl was dumped about a quarter mile off the Kailua coast.
98.6% sure?
I'm actually 100% sure. Just wanted to appear modest.
Oh, it worked. You appeared 1.4% modest. Why would somebody dump drugs out at sea?
Only one way to find out.